in the last 15-20 years. But due to shortage of time, let me summarize all my experience and the struggles that we experienced while we are accessing justice with the institution like judiciary and how the rule of law exists in the country. Since from morning around 11:30 I have been listening, but mostly it was in Hindi, I could not follow it, but some words I can understand. Mostly it was pronounced about Modi, BJP. Only that few words I can understand, but I could also guess there is a lot of clap that something is speaking against the political context here. But somewhere I feel very pity for Modi. Because he is only an instrument. The real power or real ruling is vested with the RSS and other 113 outfits of the fundamentalist organization in the country. Modi is only a kind of icon or symbol. That's why he will not speak or he will not respond to any other issues in the country. If you ask question, he will undertake international visit and travel. We know what is the outcome of the international travel. But he will speak in the radio. What is that program called? I don't know. Monkey Bar. In Tamil Nadu, people they used to ask, hey, you are in Delhi. Please tell me what is why PM Modi is giving bath to the monkey. Friends, these are all looks like very funny and what do you call the situations. But I remember late 1998 and 99 or mid-90s, there was a circular from RSS being circulated all over. It was published in the Outlook magazine, magazine that time. And whatever the agenda it was set by RSS that time, now I could see all those agendas are carried forward in the last 20 years in the country, including attack on the Dalits, Adivasis, minorities, Muslims, churches, mass, rape, gang rape, especially against Dalits, Muslims in the country. I don't want to list out the number of cases today which is happening. I really feel very ashamed. Many of the BJP activists being accused of raping minor girls in the country. And the state which I come from, there is an allegation or association linked with the governor of Tamil Nadu, where there is one women professor being, how do you say, brainwashing the students to supply to the higher officials. His name also there in the newspapers. It is really a shame how the country is really heading, and who is really heading us is the very, very dangerous situation. That's why I feel this particular building inclusive India is, I feel, very important. Particularly the kind of threat that we face in the country is very alarming. I feel apart from the class-based discrimination or ethnic-based discrimination, gender-based discrimination, but the caste is the very important aspects. The caste-based discrimination is very, very root cause of the country which still exists. You can convert your religion, but you cannot convert your caste because it is based on the birth. It's based on the birth, you cannot convert the caste. See, in India, people can live without food. They prefer to starve. but they are not ready to give up their caste. They are not ready to give up their caste. It's because the caste gives a pride. The caste is a privilege. The caste is also power. So no one wants to give that kind of questions, including people who are sitting in this hall. If you review our own questions, I think many of us may not be consciously or unconsciously, we may not be ready to give up our own caste questions. I think by making this open note, I feel that the country is facing dangerous threats to the democracy and diversity. I would feel that there are many aspects being discussed in the morning during the sessions, which is now the country is moving heading towards single party. First time I see in my experience, there is no officially recognized opposite party in the parliament. So they don't want any other parties. The single party have to rule in the country. One language, one culture, one religion, one education and one tax. But they cannot say one caste. That is very difficult. And I also feel that the state is, changing from welfare state to, corporatizations, supporting the corporates. Morning somebody were speaking about Tuticorin, I thought they are also referring to the recent incident took place in Tamil Nadu. It is true that in Tamil Nadu, 13 innocent people were shot dead by the police. There are many rules to follow before shooting anybody who are creating the law and order problem in the country. I know that the direct information from Tamil Nadu, no rules have been followed by the police. All the people were shot from the top of the van. It is not the ordinary gun. It is a machine gun. And people injured in the heart and mouth, and young lady, 17 years old lady also been shot dead. 13 people. What is the sin that they committed? They don't want this particular Sterilite company in Tamil Nadu. Not only the Sterilite company, there are many other development projects which are affecting the large number of people of their life and their livelihood. So people have a right to say that I work on this development. But Modi is saying that the entire his speech is about the development. But the kind of development which is really leading to destructions of the people. Now the Hindu fundamentalist organizations becoming very, very strong, politically strong. Not only now, since from 1989, when they captured the parliament first time, 89 seat during the VP Singh period. Since then, they are politically very powerful. I don't want to go into many other aspects, but I straight away come to one important point with regard to judiciary and rule of law. Recently, you might be here, the Apex Court of Supreme Court have come out with a new ruling with regard to Schedule Crime Prevention of Atrocities Act. The Act is enacted in 1989 in order to protect and promote the human rights of Dalit and Adivasi communities. Since many years, the untouchability practice is being continued. Discriminations and violence, every year the number is increasing. In the last 2016 NCRB report says 47,000 atrocities are reported against scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. It is only a reported numbers I'm telling you. There are many number of cases are not reported. Friends, this act, we know in 22 states, our human rights defenders are at the ground level monitoring in the last 15 years. This act is not been properly implemented. There is If you look at the percentage of the conviction, it is only below 25%. Acquittal rate is more than 75%. Which means the people who are committing crime against scheduled caste and scheduled tribe, they are left free by the court. This is not just I'm saying small crimes, including the well-known massacre killing in the country. Many cases I can quote, starting from 1968, Tamil Nadu killed very many, where 44 people were burnt alive. And very recently in Madhya Pradesh, during the 2nd April Bharat Bandh, more than 9 people were shot dead by the dominant caste, not by the police. Some media was reported it was started by the police, because the people who participated in the Bharat Bandh, they created law and order issues. It's not true. All those people were shot dead by the dominant caste. So many cases, including the Lakshmanpur Pathe, 1997, 58 people, including children, infant, women, were shot dead by the private Ranveer Sena army. Today somebody was mentioning about Cobra Post, sting operation. The same Cobra Post also conducted a sting operation called Black Rain. You can visit the website. And they did sting operation, brought out who are the people who killed the Dalits in Bihar. Not only in the Lakshmanpur Pathe, the 58 people, also more than 3,000 people. The very important news is that who are the people who promoted, financed, given training has been confessed by the Ranveer Sena army founders and the soldiers of those people. And the people, I mean the particular case, have been acquitted by High Court. Mr. Garland advocate is here, he's filed a appeal in Supreme Court, private appeal. We will not leave that particular case. But the point is what I want to make here. The people who are in the ruling now, in the ministries, I don't want to name, you can see in the website, those are the people who financed, promoted Ranveer Sena. Ranveer Sena, and they are in the ruling parties. So now my question is, one side, the court is diluted the very important provisions of the Scheduled Caste, Scheduled Tribe Criminal Atrocity in the case where it is a departmental issue, a caste-based discrimination between higher officials and the fourth class officials in a particular department. The case came to the Supreme Court to pass the FIR petition. They could have passed the petition, but rather they ruled new aspects that no anticipated bail not granted in the SSDPO Act, but now they are saying no, there is no bar for granting of anticipated bail if there is a prima facie. And arrest can be done only with the approval of the appointing authority if the public servant. If it is a non-public servant, the district superintendent of police should be approved. And if you want to file a FIR, there should be a preliminary inquiry should be conducted in 7 days, in after which the case has to be filed. I think these are very important aspects which dilutes the very important act. Now my point is, see, one side I have given an example how the ruling parties or rulers were supposed to establish the rule of law. But on the contrary, it is not been really, we are struggling with the police officials, with the number of cases. Same way the judiciary also dilutes. You know this two member bench, Goyal and Lalit. Goyal was the, his application was, when his application was this application was rejected for appointment of judge. Then another judge, Lalit, he was the senior counsel for the Amit Shah for his one of his cases. Then imagine, we have now really a fear. So the, what do you call it, the fundamentalistic RSS forces also been encroached the judiciary in the country. So the judiciary also been, not only is corrupted, it is also the fundamentalist people have been encroached the judiciaries and not only the government. So, okay, let me try to conclude. Friends, with this note, I would like to say that this particular citizens conclave, this only a limited members here. I think this need to be really taken forward to the large section of the people, because the RSS is being infiltrated in all the villages. Modi knows the trick how to play the last over ball and get the win. You know what I am saying. So we need to really work very hard for a dynamic leadership. I am not referring a leader or one person. Dynamic, democratic and leadership, I think we have more challenges in future. Thank you very much.